143 pounds, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, the Honky Tonk Man.
Can he dance?
He's horrid. Can't sing either.
Great entertainer. That's his music, Monsoon.
Yeah, I know that's his music. That's his cut off the Pile Driver album. Honky Tonk Man.
And his opponent, soon to be approaching the ring area from San Francisco, California, weighing 263 pounds, Brutus the Barber Beefcake.
Brutus the Barber Beefcake making his way down for this non-title matchup. Look at the size of that mirror. Even you could get your kisser in that one, Greg.
Yeah, I'll get my kisser in that mirror, all right. This guy's off the wall, Monsoon. He's not all there.
Take a look at that outfit.
It's like he's a hand grenade salesman.
He is a changed man since going to the finishing school of Salvatore.
Fedora.
Yes. World champion hairstylist. And look at Brutus. He's got class.
Yeah, class. Looks like the guy's been sleeping with a chainsaw.
Well, you can bet that somewhere in that attire, you're going to find some scissors, some clippers. Look at the body as well.
Oh, look at the T-shirt.
Look at it. I love it.
Boy, is that
got the old barbershop pole there and everything. How come you don't have any classy stuff like that?
I don't consider that classy stuff.
One of our lovely federettes.
Yeah.
As Brutai takes off that new T-shirt. Got his little bag of everything there, I'm sure. This guy's got some heavy dues to pay, and he could be paying some of them right now.
Now, do you think he's going to get an opportunity to cut the hair of the Honky Tonk Man?
What a thrill that would be. Honk's got a lot of hair to be cut out there. Well, earlier on, we caught up to Dangerous Danny Davis, who was one of the world's worst referees, and here's what he had to say.
I'm watching this match for one reason, to keep my eye on that referee. I don't think it's right for him to allow Brutus Beefcake to bring those scissors in the ring. It could hurt somebody or cause permanent damage. And one thing for sure, that referee better take care of business.
Three atomic drops in a row, and the Honky Tonk Man is reeling in pain. Big roundhouse right sends the champion down to the canvas. He'll be looking for some help out there.
Now, time to get a hold of the colonel. Now, see, he shouldn't. He should be disqualified for going on the floor after the man.
Yeah, none of your guys do that, right?
Well, we fight fire with fire.
Yeah, well. And
four
so, another. Look out. There's the mouth. The colonel. Attaboy, don't turn your back on him. Back inside. Brutai has been on fire up late. Look at this swing shot. Over the top. Got him down. Doesn't. Oh, couldn't hook him. See that? He couldn't hook that shoulder with a footer. He might have had it.
Who dresses Beefcake? Walt Disney?
Oh, he looks good compared to some of the garbage you wear.
Garbage.
How quickly the tide can turn here in the world of professional wrestling as a champion is not in control.
It certainly is obvious the Barber Beefcake keeps a lot of garage sales in business.
Paul got caught as he came off the second turnbuckle on the inside.
Come on, Jimmy, get him going, get him motivated.
And Colonel realizes that his man's in trouble. Irish whip in. Sleeper, he's got it right in the center of the ring.
You might see a new champion here.
This is a non-title matchup. Look at that.
Get out of Jimmy.
He caught him. And he throws a sleeper out.
There's no reason for this.
He's going to put him right out. Honky trying to sneak up from behind with the megaphone, and he wasn't successful. Brutai is everywhere.
Wait a minute, what's he going to do here now?
Resulting from a disqualification, Brutus the Barber Beefcake.
Oh, he's got the colonel.
Come on, Jimmy.
Some of them long locks, I love it.
Somebody stop him. Somebody go get the Heart Foundation.
Oh, look at this, Dangerous Danny, another member of the Heart Foundation. What a blind shot by him right in the
back. What a blind shot. The man's taking advantage of a 140-pound manager trying to cut all his hair off.
How did the 140-pound manager get in the ring?
Because he was applying a chokehold.
He dove in the ring. to save his man. It's all broken loose here now. The megaphone still laying right in the center of the ring. As there goes Danny Davis. There goes Hawk as well. They're all bailing out. And Blue Eye right after him.
Now he should be suspended for that and fined for trying to alter a man's appearance, cutting the hair of Jimmy Hart. I mean, that's bad, bad, Monsoon.
Listen to the approval of this capacity crowd as a hand raised in a token of victory on a disqualification to the barber.
Now he's stealing the man's megaphone.
Why not? He left it behind, the coward.
Oh, you can make your own rules. Whatever you see fit is good enough.
No, the match is over. Whatever's left out there goes to the winner. And there's some of the evidence.
Oh, yeah, the Survival Series is coming. I'll have a chance once and for all on Thanksgiving Day to prove to you, Fabulous Moolah, and everyone else, I am the sensational ladies champion. The Survival Series is coming.
Let me introduce you to the World Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Champion, Hulk Hogan!
Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, who do you think you are firing me? You've embarrassed me for the last time. And every member of my family's going to get even with you. I know you're jealous of this man. He's got the best physique in professional sports today. We're going to get you, Orndorff. You can bank on it.
Introducing Jimmy Hart's Glamour Girls, the women's tag team champions.
Yes, you can be sure that we are the roughest and the toughest. Right, Judy?
We're not only the roughest and toughest.
We are the glamour girls.
Kiss me, girls. Kiss me.
Well, that's another one you missed, Brain. The mouth came up with two beauties.
Yeah, he's got some glamorous girls, but that's his business. He wants to manage women. I don't have anything to do with them.
Let's go to ringside.
His tag team partners, known as the Dream Team, Dino Bravo and Greg the Hammer Valentine. Their opponents, soon to be making their way to the ring area, at a combined weight of 692 pounds, the Birdman, Coco Beware. And his tag team partners, Jumping Jim Brunzel, B. Brian Blair, the Killer Bees.
You know, I don't blame him, Monsoon. If I was going to hang out with Coco or the Bees, I'd hide my face, too.
You would, huh? Well, you're listening to the lead cut off the Pile Driver album, Pile Driver Indeed, done by Coco Beware. And it is a hot item.
A very hot item. Of course, it sounds like he's been gargling the razor blades. I know which one Coco is. He's the one with the mask.
Yeah, the one with the mask. The one with the bird on his hand, right?
Who can tell anymore?
Putting Frankie out on his perch where he'll keep an eye on everything that goes on here. I love this. This is great.
Put it back on, Coco. It's not an improvement.
I'd like to know what's going on right now in the minds of the new Dream Team and of Luscious Johnny V. Johnny V wearing that funny-looking object, black object on the top of his cranium, and you know why, Brain.
Why?
He got a baldy job from Brutus, didn't he? Brutus could give you a little trim. You need a little trim.
Brutus ever came near me with clippers, it'd be all over. Now look at the power of Bravo. We're not going to be able to match the strength of this guy. Former upper body.
Canadian heavyweight champion Dino Bravo starting this one off with B. Brian Blair and immediately goes downstairs. Six-man tag team action excitement here on Wrestling Challenge this week. And Dave Hebner.
Whoa,
what a high heel. Kick out nicely by B. Brian. Well, the latest edition of World Wrestling Federation magazine has a most interesting article in it, Brain, about Coco Beware, this guy with a hit cut off the Pile Driver album. This guy's got a lot of talent.
You may think he's got talent. I think the Honky Tonk Man has talent. I don't like Coco Beware singing.
That's what makes the world go round.
You know, I understand the bees and just Coco Tupperware here have been working out together a lot.
And Coco Beware.
Oh, Beware, I'm sorry. Can you imagine having to run around with the bees all day or Coco? What a drag.
Well, of course, the Dream Team as well as Killer Bees all involved in that 20-man tag team elimination, part of the big Survivor Series coming down Thanksgiving night. Richfield Coliseum, Richfield, Ohio. It's a happening.
I'm going to be there.
I know you're going to be there.
I'm going to watch Andre the Giant pluck all the feathers off that big 300-pound turkey.
You wish. You wish. 1987 hasn't been very good for you, Brain. Maybe this will bring a change.
I've had one major setback, but that wasn't my fault or anything.
You had a lot of major setbacks. You lost Mr. Wonderful. Look at this. Oh, he went for a monkey flip, got caught right in the middle of it.
The power of Dino Bravo.
Inverted atomic drop. Surprise, Coco.
Watch the hammer here pound on it.
Hammer going for a suplex. Right in the center of the ring. Got him up. Oh.
Whoa, doesn't even take him
off. Would have turned around and turned him loose. What a dangerous maneuver that is. No one there for the elbow, though. But look at how this team cuts the ring in half.
They know what they're doing.
Well, they certainly do.
The Bees just can't match the power of these guys. Plus, they pick Coco as a partner. What a weak link. Ooh, I'd like to get my hands around the neck.
Frankie doesn't like what's going on right now. She's showing her disapproval as the Luscious One has been tagged in. There's a tag made to one or both. You can only tag one B at a time. Referee making them both get out as he didn't see the tag. Oh, look at that. The hammer nails his manager. On Dream Street right now, Luscious Johnny B. Jumping Jim in there. He's fresh. Plants one downstairs and one for each of the Dream Team. Remisses a big roundhouse right. Atomic drop. Nailed him. Oh, there's that cranium without a whole lot of hair on it. Double whip in. Big backdrop. Tag made to Coco. Drop kick off the top turnbuckle. Over for the cover. One, two. Yes, he got three.
Well, that can't happen. You can't have that many people in the ring. They should stop it, go back, and start over.
Six men inside the ring, but the referee still went down and made the count.
Watch this, watch
this. Here are your winners, the team of the Birdman, Coco Beware, and the Killer Bees.
There, the hammer's going to snap the leg of the Coco Beware. Watch it.
Hammer slapped down to figure four right in the center of the ring. Well, this is Johnny B and his other member of the team, keeping the bees out of there, but not for long. Serious damage could be done right here.
I hope so.
I know you do. You're a sick person.
Thank you.
Well, victorious here, the killer bees. They don't look like the winners, as Coco is down and hurt. Let's go back and take a look.
They're two against one right there.
The big backdrop on the manager. And then Coco does it with that drop kick.
But he wasn't tagged. It was
right off the top turnbuckle.
Because I've been watching the corner.
You have, huh? 1, 2, 3 count with everybody in there. 6 men at one time. But it didn't stop the referee from counting down. And then the hammer went on and slapped it on.
I can hear it snap from here.
Right now, here's some interesting information about the...
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, would you please welcome my guest, Hacksaw Jim Duggan! Hacksaw, I must say, this has been quite a story. I guess it was a few weeks ago now, when you knocked the king off his throne.
Well, you know, I'm one of just a few people that are sick and tired of King Harley Race coming down here, parading around, think that he's better than everybody else. This is America, baby. This is where all men are created equal. We don't have no royalty. We don't have no kings. And King Harley Race, I took your crown away from you. I took this fancy dad cape away from you. And I've got this 2x4 to make sure that I keep it away from you. What's this?
Crown does not belong to you. That cape does not belong to you. You're nothing but a thief. You understand?
You? Wait a minute now. From behind, Duggan, turn around. Harley Race is right behind you. Race striking with that 2x4 across his shoulders and again. Harley Race. Oh no. He's wide open. Race delivers a blow to the midsection. Look at Heenan kicking over Hacksaw Jim Duggan down on the concrete floor. Oh no. Race jumping off the platform again, driving that 2x4 into the chest area, driving it again into Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Harley Race jamming that 2x4 into the midsection. No, look at this. Race with all his might just trying to drive it right down through his throat. Harley Race, get him out of there. Get that man out of there. We continue. Stay with us.
A few short weeks, the Survivor Series will take place. And let me bring on right now the man who's on the cover of this month's World Wrestling Federation magazine, led by his manager, the lovely Elizabeth, the captain of the team, Macho Man Randy Savage. I also want to introduce his team, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, Jake the Snake Roberts, Brutus the Barber Beefcake,
talking about the school of hard knocks, getting down, and these are the people that can do it. Oh yeah, Macho Madness style, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. We've gone nose to nose and we sweated against each other till we couldn't sweat no more. And everybody knows in the Survivor Series that the dragon will breathe fire. Jake the Snake Roberts. Everybody might think that this man might do it for money, but the only currency he knows is flesh and bones. Hacksaw Jim Duggan, he doesn't see too well, but take Mr. 2x4 in his hands and point him in the right direction, and he could hit a grand slam in the Survivor Series. No! Oh yeah, in the barber, Brutus the Barber Beefcake. Everyone knows that he can lean on people. But the intimidation of humiliation that this man possesses could be the coup de grace of the Survivor Series.
He will be taking on the Honky Tonk Man's team. It is only a few weeks away. What a team! It's the
Hi, folks. Look, I'm happier than a pig in a poke right now. Last week, I was out here, and I wrestled Danny Davis, and I whooped him. He was an undefeated man, and I whipped him on TV. I kind of did a hoedown on his behind, if you know what I mean. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope in the future you'll see a lot more of Sam Houston. Thank you.
How do you feel, baby? How do you feel?
You're good.
I want to prove to the Strike Force that we're the greatest tag team of all time. The greatest. You understand what I mean? The greatest.
They're not ready.
The greatest. We're going to humiliate the Strike Force once and for all. We're going to humiliate you. Come on, get that camera out of here. Get the camera out of here.
Get out of here.
Let's go. Come on, champs. Come on, baby.
It is scheduled for one fall. Entering the ring, first of all, here is the manager, the Mop of the South, Jimmy Hart. And at a total combined weight of 515 pounds, here are the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Hitman Bret Hart and Anvil Jim Neidhart, the Hart Foundation.
Great matchup. You got the speed of Strike Force going against, shall we say, the deceit and the strength of the Hart Foundation.
Jimmy Hart holding the titles in his hands, championship belts, maybe for the last time. Who knows?
Well, you know what it shows me? It shows me the Hart Foundation is ducking no one. They're wrestling champions, and especially to put their championship on the line on television. I've never heard of such a thing.
Hart Foundation to meet these two premier outlets, Santana and Martel. Come on, let's get the match underway. Jimmy Hart stalling a bit.
The biggest positive note about this whole match is at least it keeps Chico Santana off the microphone.
Now, wait a minute.
Gives those Spanish people a break.
Well, I don't think he's going to be giving the Hart Foundation a break.
I was going to say, Vince, the question is, if the Hart Foundation, even though they defend their title many times successfully, have they met anybody quite with the speed of these two, the Strike Force? I don't know.
Well, the good thing about it is they can keep their eye on Santana. He's not going to come appearing from behind the scenes, you know, jumping into the ring and stuff like that.
Nice move by Martel. Oh, my goodness! Another drop kick! Rick Martel allows you to drive kick out! Based on what we've seen just far, it appears to me that at least the Hitman is a little over-anxious.
He might be. He's probably a little tight right now. He made a mistake early, but he's not paying for it yet.
Well, the kind of speed that the Strike Force shows keeps the other two off balance, and that's what they're going to try to do, because if you can keep them off balance, you're going to do a number on them.
Look at this. Double team effort. Santana moments ago. Over to try to get to the anvil.
Now, I think the key to this match is for referee Joey Morella to make sure Strike Force is making legal tags in there.
Oh, brother.
Come on.
They like
Jesse.
Doing that quick tag and two of them in the ring at once.
Hitman. Tried to scoop him up. Santana rolled. No. Nice maneuver by the Hitman, Bret Hart.
You might fool the Hitman once, but you're not going to fool him twice.
The anvil coming out. The Anvil fighting himself in an arm bar. The Anvil with Santana, bringing him back over to the not so neutral corner, blocked by Santana. Firing off a series of rights. Look at this.
I really can't believe Santana's going to exchange with Neidhart.
But look at this, Santana hammering away. Santana is tenacious. Look to the rope. Back off to the, oh no, look at that. You saw that.
Beautiful move by Bret Hart. Bret Hart sliding down the apron, lifting the knee up, and catching Chico Santana in the small of the back.
What a cheap shot.
The angle on top of Santana. Come on, referee.
It is not a cheap shot if they win the match. Then they get a lot of money, and it can hardly be cheap.
Well, right now they got him hurt, and you can bet that the anvil is going to really work on Santana.
Well, you can see Santana's hanging on that rope. He doesn't want to get dragged into the Hart Foundation corner.
Are you looking at the same match I'm looking at?
Definitely.
Santana back to his feet. Legal tag made. Here comes the hitman again. Wide open, Tito Santana. Oh, down into the kidneys. Another shot.
You see how smart Bret Hart is. He drove that knee into the kidneys. He immediately gets into the ring and starts working on it. Here, look at the big backbreaker.
And down to the kidneys again. Cover. We have one, two, and... Ooh.
Boy, that was really close.
Hitman Bret Hart with a kick to the lower abdominal area. Jimmy Hart with that megaphone. Santana firing up. And again, has a little something behind the punches. But look at this. Held again. Ooh, for the anvil to come crashing down in the ring.
Smart tag team wrestling, though. Santana started to hit Bret Hart. And what happened? Hart's close enough to his corner to make a tag to the fresh man, the anvil. Now look at the anvil's tying the referee up. Brilliant tag team wrestling. And here comes Rick Martel illegally into the ring.
Look at that. Come on, referee. Turn around. It would be a shame if a match of this consequence or this significance ended in a controversial decision from a referee. Anvil missing, I think, with the first boot, but he sure connected with the second one.
The Hart Foundation know that their title's in danger because they're meeting group premier team here. Whoa, outside he goes. And they'll
not
pull
the
every
place to be.
Stuff.
Yes, indeed, and that's where they can really cut loose down from the apron.
And look how smart. You know, Neidhart's not just brawn. He's a smart wrestler. He tied the referee, Joey Morella, up on that. Got him talking in the ring. Didn't allow him to see Bret Hart do that on outside of the ring.
Tito Santana on the outside. Jimmy Hart a moment ago chased by Martel, but look at this. Still more damage done to Santana. Now shut back into the ring by the hitman. A cover. No. No.
Oh, all right. Look at this. Look at this now. There's Martel illegal in the ring.
Yep.
What do you mean? Neidhart, Bret Hart's been doing it throughout the match.
And the tag just about ready to be made.
No. Now fair play. Turnabout's fair play right there. It's one apiece.
The anvil just hammering and mauling Tito Santana.
I bet you Chico wishes he was back on the microphone right now. He pounds his face in the mat one more time. He will never talk on a microphone again.
The anvil with Tito Santana. And the fans really encouraging Santana and Martel to get it going. But wait a minute, look at this. Oh, no.
It could be over.
That could very well do it. Two and yes, go.
Now it looked to me like that referee paused before that third count.
He kicked out before he could come down with the count of three.
The main thing for a referee is to have a consistent count. Each count should be the same, and I feel that that count was not the same.
Santana slammed to the canvas. Oh, he missed with the elbow. Santana making his way back over the tag. Partner Martel inching over. No. The advance will stop right there.
Well, if Chico Santana doesn't make a tag pretty soon, this match is history. He's been in there a long time. He's been... The hearts have changed in and out on him three or four times. Chico's got to be running down. He don't have much left.
Well, Tito, not Chico.
Chico, that's what I said, Chico.
Oh, no, come on. This is ridiculous. And you can't blame Martel. You just can't idly stand there and watch what's going on.
But you notice he causes more damage when he comes into the ring. If he'd stay on the apron, the referee'd be there to break it up.
Oh, down. Referee, look what's happening here.
Hey, he's trying in there. You got four men in there vying for the World Tag Team Championship.
Well, there's no question the Hearts will stoop to any depth to retain the title.
Certainly. Wouldn't you?
In the ring now, the Hitman, Bret Hart. I can't believe Santana's on his feet.
The Hearts are doing nothing any different than what Bruno did when he was champion.
Oh, is that
Bruno
right?
Would stoop to any level to keep his title.
Reversal by Santana!
Bret Hart hit that turnbuckle extremely hard.
Now if only could get that out. If he can take Martel right now, they can get Hart right here. Hart is hurt. Look at him.
What a surprise maneuver by Santana with the reversal. Santana making his way over the top. And unfortunately, two fresh men in there, and look at him go toe to toe. Brad kept thinking that. Over. Rick Martel. Rick Neidhart reversal. Martel to the buckle. Throwing Red Buck out of the corner. Draw two. Oh, come on, he cut it. He could have had the world title right there.
That could have been it. If there would have been no interference, that would have been it. You would have seen new champions.
Meanwhile, Santana. Sent the Hitman reeling. Ooh, down to the midsection.
Look at this double team.
All right. That's right.
Slam. Santana gets out of there. Martel trying to get him over.
Boston Crab, submission.
Champions of the Hart Foundation. It wasn't an easy match by no means, Craig, but I guarantee you, we knew we had to do it tonight, or else they might not give us another chance. We had to put it all together.
Hey, something on your Butch Reed. This is Superstar Billy Graham, and I'm going to get down and do the boogaloo on top of your head, because Superstar Billy Graham is back. I got my act together. I'm on top of my game, and Superstar Billy Graham is going to come down on you and show you no mercy, brother.
Let me tell you something, Strix. This is just what the Natural Man's been waiting for. A one-on-one confrontation with the Fallen Star, Billy Graham. Let me tell you, next week right here, Butch Reed's going to show you how Natural Man takes care of a superstar.
Billy, Jack Haynes, and Patera, you were the one that started the problem. And what happened? We broke you right in half.
Smash, are these two guys dumb or what? They couldn't beat us when they snuck up, and now we're face to face.
Demolition, you've created a problem that you're not going to be able to solve, but we're going to solve it once and for all when we get you in the ring one more time.
Demolition, blood is thicker than water. You're big, you're bad, you're tough, but family will prevail in the...
That idiot, the animal, he couldn't even find the building. He got lost. So you know what that means? It means another victory for the Million-Dollar Man. Of course, I like to win by competing, but yet a victory is a victory, and a victory means more of this. And I like all of that I can get.
Well, DiBiase, in fact, gets a victory in the record book and gets the money as well to put more in his pocket. But we've got an outstanding match headed your way right now. Oh, there she goes. Went right after Dino Bravo.
These people are cheering a dog biting a human. Can you imagine that?
The hammer got out of there in a hurry.
Shows you what our society's getting to.
Actually, I have to give credit where credit is due, Brain. I have to say you're absolutely right. This would be a main event in any arena in the entire world.
Of course I'm right. I'm Bobby the Brain Heenan.
Oh, excuse me. Sorry, I meant you. Got rid of. Nice shoulder block by Dino. Sends Davey Boy down. Quickly dropped down in front. Look out. Leapfrog. Beautiful. High hip lock. Nailed him with it. Deep arm drag. Dino wants out. I don't blame him. He didn't do anything right.
It's early. Stick around.
Excuse me. Tag made also on the other side, and Dynamite's in there now. Another nice shoulder block. He's back to 100%. Watch him. Look at it. Snap suplex. Nailed him with it.
And what does Greg go about? 270?
Absolutely.
I'll tell you one thing about this team of the Bulldogs. They do quick tags. That's what you have to do.
You want to survive in tag team action, you better know how to operate inside that squared circle. Nice single leg trip by the hammer.
Speaking of surviving in survival series, that the 10-man tag match is going to be something.
Well, it certainly is. And the interesting point of view from my side of the story is that even when you're eliminated, your partner's got to go as well. He's got to get out.
That's right. But if you want to put some money on it and make a little side bet, I'd put my money on the Islanders.
You would, huh?
Yes, I would.
Well, it's Turkey Day, and you may be the turkey.
I've never been a turkey.
Dino caught him coming in. Rammed the knee right into the kisser of Dynamite. And the tide has turned here in this one. Elbow. Nailed him with it. Could be all over. Nope.
How's Dino doing now, huh, Loudmouth?
Well, hey. The Dream Team was a great combination when it had Brutus the Barber Beefcake as one of their members.
But they dumped him, and now they're even better.
The hammer now going to work on the leg in the lower abdomen with that shot, but you can bet he's going to be trying to soften up those legs. Boy, he telegraphed that move.
A little too much. Oh, Davey Boy was standing there doing nothing.
Wasn't paying attention. Almost kicked Matilda off the apron.
Should have kicked her in the third row.
Oh, here he goes now. We talked about it earlier on. Oh, he went for it. Got caught, rammed right into the turnbuckle. Look at this windup. He won't get it. He'll be out of there.
He wound up once too many times.
He's looking to get out, make a hasty retreat. Makes the tag to Dino. And the tag is made to Davey. Both fresh men in. Davey Boy Smith, Irish whip. Big backdrop. Whoa. Excuse me, Valentine hadn't even got out of there yet. Davey Boy gave him a little assistance. Power slam, perhaps. Tag is made. There it is.
Davey Boy's illegal. Oh, he shouldn't be in there.
The tag. Are you blind?
But he shouldn't be in there.
Oh, look at that. Luscious came in and pulled the leg of Dynamite right off the shoulders of Davey Boy. Now they're all in there. The bell is rung. I would assume we've had a disqualification here. Oh, the hammer just got nailed. He's out of there. Both Dynamite and Davey going out now.
Oh, no, they're going to stick the dog on him.
I hope so. Oh, there she goes. Matilda driving him right back towards the locker room. Look at Dino running for his life. And here comes Matilda. She's going to do a number again.
Wait, Johnny V is trapped. They've got him trapped.
Luscious is caught right in the center of the ring. Oh, double headbutt. He's in no man's land right now. Suplex coming up. The bell is still ringing.
Can't anybody stop this?
They've got
the
a man,
the manager.
What's this? Got him straddled up there.
Uh-oh. They could break the man's back doing
it. Oh, we're going to see a suplex. Yes. I believe it's
Two against one. Two against one.
Let's get the official word. The winners of this bout resulting from a disqualification, the British Bulldogs.
Bulldogs getting a duke here on a disqualification, but Luscious is really out of it. Oh, look at that. Until this protection.
That's disgraceful. That is downright disgraceful.
I love it.
He better get some medical help.
He certainly will need it right now. Matilda is protecting him. Right now, let's go to a special interview with the Hulkster and his survival.
Gentlemen, as you know, in just a few short weeks, the World Wrestling Federation will be presenting one of the most unique and star-studded cards ever. It's the Survivor Series on Thanksgiving evening. And right now, I want to bring out one of the captains of the participating teams, led by his manager, the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart, the Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion, the Honky Tonk Man. Jimmy Hart, as you know, this is serious business. What are you doing with a bunch of dolphins?
Well, you see, this is the Ricky the Dragon Steamboat stretch now. And here's the Macho Man stretch now. But me and Honky, we'd like to have an Elizabeth stretch now, wouldn't we, Honky?
She's gonna wish she was a doll. Let me say this to you, Macho Man. If you have her there on Thanksgiving night, and she sets foot in the ring again to try to help you, to try to save you, or to try to touch or kiss me, you think she was humiliated, you think she was embarrassed, you think she was hurt on Saturday night's main event. That is nothing to what's going to happen to her on Thanksgiving night, because you're going to have nothing to be thankful for. I want to say this, I'll say it right now. My team, the number one team in Survivor Series, they promised me that they would take care of the opposition. Ricky the Dragon, Steamboat, Jake the Snake, Hacksaw Jim Duggan, Brutus Beefcake, and they said they would handle them real good. You show them what they're going to do to the opposition, Jimmy.
Look at this, baby. Look at him. Like a pretzel, Honky. Like a pretzel, baby.
And for you, Macho Man, stretch him out, Jimmy. Hold him up there. Listen to him scream!
Oh, no, Honky! Don't hit me! Don't hit me, Honky!
I'm gonna get you, big boy!
Don't hit me!
Now you be there, Macho! It's me and you have Elizabeth there, because she's gonna get more than hurt! She's gonna be drug away from there, because I'm not done with you!
It's going to be one spectacular the Survivor Series on Thanksgiving evening!
Brothers, next week, my man Nikolai Volkov gonna get down one-on-one with Jake the Snake Roberts. And you know, brother, if you pull out that slimy snake, then Comrade Zukov gonna take care of the situation, yeah.
I know what you're thinking. 310 pounds of Russian might be a little bit too much for me, but why don't you touch the snake and feel him grow, because he's more than what you want to handle. Now, they say, Zukov, you're going to be there. And Slick, I know you're sure to be there, but I think you're a little bit superstitious, or you wouldn't be bringing Zukov down to take care of Damien. I just don't think any of you can get the job done.
Four, one fall. Introducing in the ring, accompanied by his personal bodyguard, Virgil, making his autumn residence in Bel Air, California, weighing 260 pounds, the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase. And his opponent from Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing in at 306 pounds, the Junkyard Dog.
Well, once again, everyone, welcome to Green Bay, Wisconsin, and the Brown County Veterans Memorial Arena. Bruce Pritchard at ringside, and joining me this week, Mike McGurk, along with wrestling great Nick Bockwinkel. And Nick, it's great to have you here this week, and what a tremendous matchup we have in the ring.
And I guess it's starting right away. I would say they're not getting off to a slow start in the slightest way.
Not at all. Ted DiBiase being sent into the ropes and a high backdrop on the Junkyard Dog.
I'm sure that was not his plan. But of course, if he wants to pay attention to money, he's going to get himself in trouble, and Ted DiBiase is going to be right there to take any kind of advantage of it he can.
And the Dog now with the third Ted DiBiase, and on the outside of the ring, Mike, the ever-present manservant, Virgil.
Absolutely. He's always there for his man to either back him up or do whatever that Ted
say, Junkyard Style Dog has got style.
Indeed, Ted DiBiase on the outside of the ring with Virgil, a little bit higher ground.
Yeah, he's taking a smart move right now. He's figuring Junkyard Dog jumped all over him. And he figures, well, I'm going to take advantage of that 10 count as long as I can. I'm going to enjoy myself, get a breather, because he knows when he steps back into these ropes, he's going to possibly have hell to pay if he can't take and get the job done.
That's right, Nick. The Dog shows no intimidation of DiBiase or what he stands for and all the money that he has.
Well, you and I would have to agree, no matter how much money you got in your pocket, when you're in the middle of that ring, it doesn't make any difference rich or poor. You know,
it doesn't matter what's so bad. The only thing that matters is winning.
The one thing Ted DiBiase has not been able to do in the World Wrestling Federation is buy off any of his opponents inside that square circle.
Well, having spent some time in that square circle in my lifetime, I can tell you this. Yeah, we're all an egotistical bunch of athletes. When you get all those muscles and all that power and all that belief in yourself, it's strange. Money, I don't think, can conquer egos, but egos can conquer money.
Ted DiBiase now on the outside of the ring, and he's trying to slow down the pace of this match a little bit.
To his advantage.
No question. You know, if somebody's pressing you hard, I'm a results man. Whichever one gets the job done, somebody's going to say, well, he's a coward for running out of the, stepping under the apron and stepping off outside the ropes. But then what do all the smart quarterbacks in the NFL do? And I'm sure Junkyard Dog has chased a few of them right off to the sidelines, and they call that smart football.
Good point. The Junkyard Dog right now and the referee cautioning him to open up the fist.
Well, it's a cute ploy on the part of DiBiase. Anytime you want to stop that pace, you make that fist. Let the referee see you've made that fist, and he's going to step in between you, and then you've got a little more time.
DiBiase now going to work on the Junkyard Dog, and not too smart of a move, as the Dog almost enjoys.
Doesn't faze the Dog whatsoever.
Mike, can I ask you, are women known to have as hard a head as a lot of men?
I think that's going to go unanswered right now. people who know me might give you that answer.
I see. Well, I'm sure there's a lot of women out there who would probably think there's a lot of hard-headed men.
Goes both ways, that's true.
For sure.
Well, possibly, Nick, DiBiase, maybe a little bit of a psychological edge on the Junkyard Dog now, staying on the outside of the ring, not wanting to face him in the middle of the ring.
Well, you know, when you're a true athlete, you want to get right into the battle. This cat and mouse game that DiBiase is playing starts to really wear. It breaks the rhythm, it breaks the tempo. Talk to golfers, and they'll tell you they hate to wait on a tee because the golf course breaks up. They're getting into the Junkyard Dog now.
Indeed, this capacity crowd here in Green Bay really getting behind the Junkyard Dog as they chant JYD and DiBiase not at all happy.
It'd be kind of hard for Mr. DiBiase to buy off this crowd, don't you all think?
Any crowd, darling.
Well, Nick, I'll ask you, as I've asked Mike in the past, Ted DiBiase claims everyone has a price. And I'll ask you the same question. Does Nick Bockwinkel have a price?
Sure. Now we just got to squabble about it.
Junkyard Dog now twisting the arm of one Ted DiBiase. And DiBiase shakes his head no as the referee asks him if he's ready to submit.
Oh, he's using that headbutt. I mean, he's got a lot of power, and let's give him credit for having a hard head. And there's no question, if he can, it's bigger than a foot, it's bigger than a fist, and it's harder than all of them. And if he can run that into his shoulder or into his arm, give it the Charlie horse, and incapacitate that arm, then he's going to have an advantage.
Ted DiBiase now suckering the Junkyard Dog into the corner. The Dog reverses and sends DiBiase right into that turnbuckle. Beautiful clothesline that time by the Junkyard Dog. And the Dog now threatening DiBiase, and DiBiase goes right outside once again, Mike.
Where his man Virgil is to back him up. And again, as Nick said earlier, he's using this psychology and maybe also to get a breather, too. He needs it. He stepped in with one of the best seasoned veterans that you have around here in the World Wrestling Federation, Junkyard Dog.
Now Ted DiBiase making his way back into the ring, and a lot slower than maybe the last couple times.
Well, he wants to make sure. I mean, both these men, there's no question, it's the World's Heavyweight Championship someplace down the line. To become the World Wrestling Federation's Heavyweight Champion is what they want. And so a win or a loss here is a credit for one and discredit to the other.
Both men wanting a win out of this match, too.
That hurts.
And DiBiase not in a good way now as Junkyard Dog bears down on the left arm of DiBiase. And the twist brings DiBiase right down to his knee.
Good consistency on Junkyard Dog's part because he's staying on the arm. He was headbutting it before. He gave it a few kicks, an elbow, and now he's working on both the elbow and the shoulder.
That's right, Nick. You find the man's weakest spot and you work on it, wear him down for the 1-2-3. Hopefully.
DiBiase now backs the dog into the ropes, referee, and DiBiase full aware of the referee's count. Low into the midsection now as DiBiase has the dog on the ropes and not in a good way. Nice maneuver that time by the Junkyard Dog, and that time he might have gone to the well one too many times.
Anytime you miss anything, a drop kick, a punch, an elbow, it throws your rhythm off and you wind up hurting yourself very badly.
And DiBiase now with a series of elbow smashes and goes right to the choke. And if you notice, DiBiase breaks right on the referee's four count.
This is smart business. I mean, you can do whatever you want within that four count as long as he doesn't say five. And you're allowed to do it as long as you break on four.
Nice notice. Shot there of Virgil.
Yeah.
On the bodyguard of Ted DiBiase.
Notice that look off of Virgil.
This capacity crowd here at Green Bay, once again, behind the Junkyard Dog, 110%. Knee drop and DiBiase once again, now going for the cover. Only two, not enough to keep the Junkyard Dog down.
The man is strong, there's no question about that. DiBiase weighs right in that 270-pound range, and he just shoved him up in the air.
Whip into the ropes. Nice elbow smash that time by the Million Dollar Man.
Again, DiBiase's been consistent here from the time that the Junkyard Dog missed that headbutt. He's been staying right on him, right on his head. He's been stomping him, kicking him, whatever is necessary with those elbows.
Indeed, Ted DiBiase, known as a master ring tactician. And now he made another little psychological ploy as he plays to the crowd a little bit. Sheer confidence.
Well, I'd hope that those few seconds that he took admiring himself to the crowd doesn't back up on him and having given Junkyard Dog a little breather.
That's true. His ego was stepping in when he could have got in there and wear him down.
Now DiBiase, after letting the dog back to his feet, stays on him as the referee cautioned DiBiase about the use of the ropes. Maybe it's not so much confidence as it may be conceit, Nick.
Well, it's a combination of all of those. It's confidence, it's conceit, it's ego. And in those few seconds, this may be, let's see how he does. Let's see how it turns out for DiBiase.
From the second row, DiBiase that time is sent by the big fist of the Junkyard Dog.
You saw it.
And Virgil is upset.
Showing his disapproval.
Well, Junkyard Dog just sucked him right in. He laid there. Led DiBiase, you got it. And I mean, it was smart business on the part of the dog.
Playing possum and Junkyard Dog using his head literally.
The knee, he hit him in the knee first, now in the head.
And that time, Virgil trying to make his way into the ring, only to be met by the hard head of the Junkyard Dog.
Oh, outstanding.
And that time, Virgil attracting the attention of the Junkyard Dog, and the dog on the outside. Some happy fans here in Green Bay, Wisconsin, and the dog meets DiBiase on the outside with a big headbutt. Interesting confrontation here between Virgil and JYD. And DiBiase rolls back into the ring, and the Junkyard Dog, seeing the referee's count, makes his way back in. DiBiase hasn't covered. This may be it. He has a handful of tights there. Word.
Here is your winner, the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase.
The winner of the match, the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase. And we'll take you back right now to the replay and see exactly how Ted DiBiase did it. Ted DiBiase bringing the Junkyard Dog in for a body slam, and the dog a little bit
there
too much. And handful of tights right there, but he got the three count.
That's all he needs for a little leverage.
The winner of the match, the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase from Green Bay, Wisconsin, for Mike McGurk and Nick Bockwinkel. I'm Bruce Pritchard. Stay tuned for more World Wrestling Federation action.
Ladies and gentlemen, about a week and a half in the Survivor Series, the main event. Hulk Hogan's team will take on the team I have with me right now, led by the managers, the Doctor of Style Slick, and of course the Brain Bobby Heenan.
You know, when you look around, you wonder how anybody can survive getting in the ring with the Natural Butch Reed, King Kong Bundy, the one-man gang, ravishing Rick Rude. I'm in one corner, he's in the other corner, and captained by this man, the eighth wonder of the world, and next heavyweight champion, Andre the Giant. But there's something I think everybody should see. You see, after Hogan gets through hiding behind the likes of Orndorff and the likes of Patera and Bam Bam and his other partner, then he is gonna have to step in that ring. Hogan, that 300-pound blonde turkey, is gonna have to step in that ring. And eventually, he's gonna have his hands full with Andre the Giant. But let me show you a little something. I happen to have a nice little toy here. It's the brand new Hulk Hogan stretch doll. Now watch, what happens if the Natural grabbed an arm? And let's say, oh, Bundy took this arm. And then what happened if the one-man gang grabbed a leg? Well, what if Ravishing Rick Rude grabbed the other leg? What would be left to grab?
I don't think you're showing much respect for the heavyweight champion. You know why? Because what you see assembled here is a congregation of sophistication, brother. And when it all boils down to that, these men are gonna destroy that Hulk Hogan and those bombs.
You know what he's gonna look like? You know what he's gonna look like?
We'll find out on Thanksgiving Eve, the main event of the Survivor Series.
Who does this guy think he is? Sam Houston, drugstore cowboy, facing dangerous Danny Davis on TV, and the officials giving him the match. Well, let me tell you something, son. Next time we meet, I'm going to teach you something you can't learn down on the ranch.
Yeah, Danny Davis, you're a little bit mad at me right now, and that's fine and dandy with me. My pa always told me, he said, son, there's a couple of things you got to learn in life. Some men you got to whip twice. Anytime you want to jump in the ring, you just jump on in the ring, and I'll come out there dancing. I'll do a hoedown on your behind again.
Gentlemen, we have heard about him for some time now. He claims everybody's got a price. Introducing, led by his bodyguard, Virgil, the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase.
Well, 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 the Million Dollar Man is here. And as you can all see, I'm accompanied by my man, Virgil. And in one hand, Virgil has a basketball. Poor man's sport, basketball, right, Virgil? It's very easy to play basketball. All you need is a ball, a hoop, and an old raggedy pair of tennis shoes. Not like the expensive games that I play. They take Lear jets, limousines, but that's another story. And then the other hand, Virgil has just a small sampling of the Million Dollar Man's millions. And I know that looks like a lot of money to most of you people. As I look around the crowd, it's obvious to me that most of you would do just about anything for a little bit of my money. And I'll tell you what, being the generous individual that I am, I'm going to give somebody here
the opportunity. Look at that, Virgil. Look at the hands waving already. They all want a shot at the money. I'm going to give somebody here the opportunity to make some of my money. Now, all you got to do to make some of my money tonight is bounce the ball. Now, I know that's real difficult for most of you people because you can't chew gum and walk at the same time, but all you got to do is bounce the ball. Now, who wants to make $500? Look at that, Virgil. Look at the poverty. Let's look around here. Let's see who we're going to pick here. Let me see. Okay. We got us a little basketball player right here. Security, let's bring him up here. Bring him up here, right here. Come right on up here, son. Okay. Get around here where I can see you now. What's your name, son? Sean. Okay, Sean. Can you dribble a basketball? You can dribble a basketball, okay. Virgil, give him the basketball. Now let me see, can you dribble that basketball 10 times? Let me see you dribble the basketball 10 times. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good, oh, okay, pick the ball up, Virgil. Well, I'll tell you what I'm gonna do, Sean. If you can dribble this basketball 15 times consecutively without missing, look at here, I'm gonna give you $500. Now I know you and your family could use $500. I can tell by looking at you that you could use a lot more than 500 bucks. Okay. Virgil, give him the basketball. Okay, Sean, 15 times. Ready, go. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Oops! We didn't get to 15, Sean. You didn't get to 15, did you? No, he didn't make 15. And you know what that means? What that means, Sean, is you've got to learn a hard, cruel fact of life. When you don't do the job right, you don't get paid.
Ladies and gentlemen, this contest is scheduled for one fall. About to approach the ring area, he will be led by his manager, the Doctor of Style, Slick. And from Kansas City, Missouri, weighing 255 pounds, the Natural Butch Reed.
Oh man, that music is too much. It's Jive, all right. I don't know if it's Jive Soul Bro or not.
His opponent, from Paradise Valley, Arizona, weighing 258 pounds.
What an ovation.
Superstar, Billy Rhea.
What an ovation. Look at this capacity crowd. All standing in appreciation for the superstar.
Tell you what, ovations don't win you matches. That's for sure.
Reed all over superstar Billy Graham.
He didn't even let the superstar get into the ring before he nailed him.
Maybe he was afraid to. Maybe he figured if he gave him a fair chance, it might mean trouble for Reed, huh, Jesse?
That might be true, Bruno, but you do whatever works.
Ah, baloney. This is disgusting. Let the man in the ring and be a man and start the match properly.
Natural Butch Reed just hammering away.
You know, you're a fine one to talk about that, Bruno. I remember when you jumped Billy Graham the same way.
And look at this.
It's all over his hip.
That's right.
Why not?
Why not?
He knows it's a weak spot.
Oh,
he knows
wait a minute. Look at that.
He knows that's his Achilles heel. If Graham can't take it, he shouldn't be in there.
Wait a minute if he can take it.
Wait a minute.
What a chair.
Wait a minute. Come on. The Slickster distracting the referee.
You know what this shows me? This shows me that Slick that Slick and Reed were prepared when they came into that ring, and Billy Graham was not.
The Slickster, not much in the way of a managership, many say, but the one-man gang high on the Slickster, just as the natural Butch Reed is. Here's what the gang had to say.
There's a lot of bad rap going down on the Slickster. Will you people lighten up on the Slickster, because he's the greatest manager in professional wrestling right now. I believe that, and a natural believes that, and he's promised us to take us all the way to the top in the WWF.
All the way to the top, huh?
You know, the interesting thing about this match so far is superstar Billy Graham has showed virtually no offense whatsoever.
That's true.
None.
Oh, wait a minute! Superstar! Look at that! Right across the... Oh, wait a minute! Oh, yeah!
Hey! Now, he had no reason to bring Slick into the ring.
Well, was Slick going on the apron? He doesn't belong on the apron. Good. Should pick him up and throw him over those top ropes. Teach him a lesson once and for all.
Hit it!
Come on, Billy, hit him!
He's a manager. What do you mean, hit
him? Hit him! He deserves it. He's always interfering.
Superstar Bearhead! Oh, wait a minute. One man gang! The gang coming in! Sending the Slickster!
This shows me right here, you want to mess with the manager, then you're going to pay for it. Because there's a lot of loyalty in wrestling between wrestlers and their managers.
What are they doing to him? Oh, no, got across the hip.
Right on that hip, too. Right on the bad hip. Look at that. About 400 and some odd pounds. Look at
that. Oh, my goodness. What are they trying to do to him?
I'll tell you what they're doing. They're going to end this career. That's what they're trying to do.
They're going to send him back to the doctor again. You mean to tell me we're going to have to watch one of those bloody operations?
Morocco go.
That was in Morocco cleaning house, and there we saw him earlier on. Morocco out there with Reed. And the long man gang.
Billy Graham's hurt.
Better believe he's hurt with what he took on that bad hip.
Well, he shouldn't be in there then. If he's not physically
he should be in there. The man attacked him with a chair and everything else.
Oh, come on. Come on now. Morocco and Reed down toe to toe. Look out, the gang. I can't believe what he just did.
He dropped that superstar Billy Graham right out on the floor. And the problem for Morocco is there's just too many of them.
We'll be back right after this. Stay with us. We'll be back. Superstar Billy Graham. We're taking him out. We may have seen the last of the superstar. What an ovation for this man, though. What a gallant effort.
I believe the gang and Butch Reed have given Billy Graham mandatory retirement.
Superstar. On the stretcher. Let's take you now to comments pre-recorded by the Dragon Ricky Steamboat. And after that, comments from the Honky Tonk Man.
The Dragon's back and breathing some fire. Got you next week, Honky Tonk. Going around playing a tune, stepping on people's feet, pushing women down. Think you're big time now. Bragging about it. Having a good time with that belt. The only one that's going to be pushed down is you. Next week, way down.
You looking for trouble? You come to the right place. And next week, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, I'm going to prove to you and everybody else that I'm the greatest Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion of all time. I got a special tune picked out just for you, Dragon.
Introducing first the individual accompanied by his manager, the Doctor of Style, Slick, and his tag team partner, Boris Zukov, from the Soviet Union, weighing 313 pounds, Nikolai Volkov. And ladies and gentlemen, at the request of the Doctor of Style and Mr. Volkov, they ask that you please rise and respect Mr. Volkov's singing of the Soviet national anthem.
Ah, yours, let us
Right, he gave us a short version.
Well, and his opponent from Stone Mountain, Georgia, weighing 249 pounds, Jake the Snake Roberts.
Standing ovation by this capacity crowd for Jake the Snake Roberts as he makes his way down. What's Boris Zhukov doing in the ring?
He's his partner. First of all, these people weren't standing for Jake the Snake. They were standing from the singing of the Russian national anthem.
I know he's his partner, Brain, but this is not a tag team match. It's a single action.
He has a right to be there. He's not going to
be involved. No right to be there.
He's not going to interfere.
Yeah. Tell me about it. Bad enough you've got the Slickster out there.
Look at the head on. See, he attacked Zhukov. Didn't he now?
Started right off the bat. Knew that Zhukov would be up to no good in there. As the big Russian gets the upper hand right off the bat, lowering the boom on Jake the Snake Roberts. We've seen Jake the Snake absorb a whole lot of punishment in the past. We know what his credentials are. Irish whipping. Oh, knee went downstairs once again.
He's a very cruel man, Jake the Snake. Any man that likes to hang around with a 25-foot python or bull constrictor is a sick man.
Random almost clotheslined him in the corner, and he comes back with a couple of quick lefts and a big right. As we look over the shoulder, oh, look at that cranium. Well, earlier on, we had a chance to catch up with Jake the Snake Roberts, and he talks about the Bolsheviks as a tag team, but he's got sort of a silent partner.
Now, I know they're a great tag team. They call themselves the Bolsheviks. But that's all right, you know, I've always stood alone, always walked my own way. But at times, oh yeah, at times, I might have a partner of my own in the bag, so to speak.
Well, partner indeed, Damian can make people do strange things as the tide has turned in this one. Oh! Look at that, what is that? Do you see that?
Well, look at what Jake the Snake did to Zhukov's shirt. He ripped his shirt.
More outside interference.
He kicked at Zhukov.
Look at that. Couple of cheap shots. Come on, ref, turn around.
Monsoon, they're Russian. They don't understand all the rules.
Yeah.
You got to give them a little slack.
Please. You're pleading the case for the Bolsheviks?
Well, I know
you're upset, Brent. The Islanders didn't get the tag team championship of the world. It went to Strikeforce. I know you're upset about that. But try to be legitimate.
Of course I'm upset. We should have had that match. But they're going to be the shortest-lived champions in the history of professional wrestling.
We'll see.
We'll see.
Roberts in trouble. Look at that blatant chokehold. Referee Joe Morella right on top of it. Any further damage could be done.
Look at the size of the head on Zhukov.
Got to be about a size 13 or 14.
I'm shooting for 53.
Well, average person would be around a 6.5. Strange shape to it. Irish whip in again. Oh, ducks underneath the big right hand. Low, he pulled his butt.
No.
Zhukov grabbed the leg of Roberts. Plants a knee down in the chest. 1, 2. No, he kicked out.
You know what happened? I believe his leg went out from under him.
He pulled it. I saw it.
I think his knee buckled. From my viewpoint.
I'm going to get you some additional glasses. Look at this. Nikolai runs into his own partner. Reached down underneath from behind. He got out. And Zhukov in the ring immediately. Lowering the boom on Roberts. Now it's 2-1 with the Slickster in there. Really doing a number on him. Jake's in deep trouble here.
He looks so tough now, doesn't he, Monsoon?
Well, it's 3-1 in there, Brent.
Russian rules apply.
Yeah. Do whatever you can, whenever you can. Let's get the official word.
The winner of this bout, Jake the Snake Roberts.
Oh, look at this. He's opening the bag up. We know what's in there. 15 or 20 feet of python.
Move it.
As they
move it.
Look at, they don't have a clue. And it's around the neck of Zhukov. And Volkov. And boy, did they make a hasty retreat.
Well, of course, that snake's a dangerous animal.
Well, so are the Bolsheviks.
And believe me, Jake the Snake
knows
it now.
Take a look, Brain. Sooner or later, he's going to be headed right for you.
And now joined by perhaps one of the largest groups ever assembled on one platform together,
But gentlemen, I'm wondering, size is not going to be all that you're going to need.
Well, you know, they say only the strong cell survive, baby. Bobby the Brain, Slickster, and Mr. Fuji, I promise you this, the foundation, the captains will be ready.
Well, there's Demolition. There's the Heart Foundation, the Dream Team, my team, the Islanders, the Bolsheviks. You tell me how the Bees, the Ragu Brothers, you tell me how, what's some of the other teams? They escape me right now.
The Young Stallions are in there.
Italian,
what about Strike Force?
Strike Force and everybody else. How are they going to survive this?
The Ruggiero Brothers as well, we may not have mentioned.
Listen, let me tell you something, brother. What you see here is 10 of the finest athletes in the world today, represented by 4 of the greatest minds. And on Thanksgiving evening, it's going to be a dog fight, dog world, baby.
Perhaps we can get a word with Mr. Fuji as well, one of the other managers.
Let me tell you, Demolition will survive because I, Mr. Fuji, personally, is sure that they will survive every team.
And one more thing, gentlemen, let me represent Mr. Fuji, the Slickster, Jimmy Hart. Thanksgiving night, all of you can have your pick of those 10 turkeys across the ring from us, because there's going to be a survivor, and the survivor's going to be Mr. Fuji, Jimmy Hart, the Slickster, and Bobby the Brain Heenan. Survive! 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 Survive!
Well, 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 well. By this time, all of you readily will admit that you've got a price. I've proven it time and time again, and as time goes on, I'll continue to prove it. As a matter of fact, the very producer of this show had his price, little guy. And that's why the footage you're about to see is courtesy of the Million Dollar Man at his best.
But the measure of a man,
understand,
is more than your common pattern.
It's the way I'll make you eat those words that matter.
If you only knew what I'm gonna do to you, you'd be running out of here as fast as 2 feet could carry you. Your destiny belongs to me. If you only knew.
Got some real bad news.
And it may involve your body.
You've been talking too much, too long, too loud.
But you ain't scaring nobody.
You see, talk is cheap when you can't keep your promise of destruction.
I think you'll see, because of me,
you'll need reconstruction.
If you only knew what I'm gonna do.
Beefcake, you may be cutting and strutting, but next week it's one-on-one with me, Dangerous Danny Davis. And if you think you're going to touch Danny Davis, you're wrong, because Danny Davis might do some strutting of his own.
Danny Davis next week, one-on-one, you and me. I can hardly wait. I'll do a bit of cutting up.
Don Morocco, of course, it is an unfortunate situation what happened to Superstar Billy Graham, but you got to be there to take his place.
Survival, professional wrestling, the words go hand in hand. The word came down from the prophet. He said, go to Hulk Hogan. Go to Ken Patera. Go to Paul Orndorff. Go to Bam Bam Bigelow. It's about survival. You got a team now. You got a place to be. Andre the Giant, I am with the Hulkster. I have found the power.
Gentlemen, the Survivor Series is upcoming this Thursday night, and I have some of the combatants in the main event. Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff, Ken Patera, Oliver Humperdinck, Don Morocco, and Bam Bam Bigelow. Where is the captain? Who's the captain of them?
Depending on him for that, man. Check out the strongest man in the world, Ken Patera. If he has to, he'll push the whole Coliseum over. As far as you, Mr. Wonderful, I didn't ask for your word. All I want you to do is make a stand.
But I'm standing here right now.
Since you're making a stand, I'll know you'll survive.
You got it.
But you know something, man? The prophet, superstar Billy Graham, predicted that man would rise against man, family against family in that WWF. And the blessing in disguise, brother, is a magnificent Morocco. Look at the hoses, brother. All we want you to do, Morocco, dig deep down in your past, where you used to be, the sins of mankind, and help us survive. Ask them if they're ready to survive.
The word came down from the superstar, the prophet, Hulkamania, Survival Rush, wow, and Richmond Coliseum. This Thursday night, we will survive. All of us will survive.
Don't miss it this Thursday night.
I'm doing what I usually do before a big match, playing a tune. And when I get to the ring, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, I'm gonna play a tune on you.
Yeah, he's gonna stretch you, and he's gonna twist you like a pretzel steamer.
Thursday night, at home with a telly on.
Ladies and gentlemen, this contest is for the Intercontinental Championship. It is scheduled for one fall. Approaching the ring area, the challenger from Hawaii, weighing 237 pounds, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Ah, he is something else. What a great competitor. What an ovation for the Dragon. Let me ask you, I mean, would you stand up there with all of us? Whoa, wait a minute! Here's the Macho Man. The match starts. Here's Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Jake the Snake. The Barber Brutus Beefcake. Who can play that game, Jesse?
Well, we could end up with the Survivor Series erupting early right here.
What a chop by the Dragon. Honky Tonk takes a shot from the Dragon. Another chop. Another one. Another one. Wait a minute. Honky Tonk with a nice reversal. Honky Tonk missing with a wild right here. What a chop again by the Dragon.
Well, so far it's been all the Dragon early in this bout.
Uh-oh.
Whoa, but there, you saw Steamboat in the cardinal mistake. He dropped his head down. He didn't watch the Honky Tonk man, and Honky was able to drop that elbow on him.
Listen, I don't deny the Honky Tonk man is one of the great competitors. The way he goes about everything.
Hey, all I'm saying is Steamboat made a major mistake there in dropping his head down and not watching it.
Maybe made a mistake, but the match is far from being over, Jesse. When you have two tough competitors.
Whoa, don't go out there. He better not go out there. What a maneuver by the Dragon. Drops it, Honky over the top. And who's out there with him? Ah, yeah.
Hey, what's Savage doing up on the apron?
Look at it. Whoa. New champion. Oh, look at this, the Dragon
is going to the top.
Yes, he is all the way up to the top now.
Oh, here we go.
Oh, two and three.
Oh. No, it's just two.
Drop close. Well, that was about 2 3/4.
Nice reversal, but look at that maneuver. The cover, that'll do it for sure.
Whoa.
You got to hand it to Honky Tonk. He could have been pinned 3 times already, and he's managed to kick out.
Yeah. Watch this.
Whoa.
Went to the well once too often.
Honky Tonk man now. With the advantage.
And this is where Honky Tonk is good, when the other man is hurt.
The Dragon trying to fight his way out of the corner. And he goes over the rope. It's all over for him. With those monsters out by ringside.
They're not going to interfere.
No, they went big on it.
How are they going to interfere when you got 4 other ones on the other side of the ring?
They'll find a way. They'll manage.
I just want to see a fair matchup here. Honky Tonk with a right hand.
You know, I think they got you and Bruno psyched out.
Whoa! So close. Honky Tonk looking with disdain a moment ago. Thought he had the Dragon. Dragon rips him up in a score package.
Oh, what a beautiful short elbow there by the Honky Tonk man.
I'll grant you that.
Caught Steamboat flush on the jaw and dazed him.
Is this smart, not Jesse?
No, it's not. He should have followed it up immediately.
Honky Tonk showboating to make
but you know, sometimes your adrenaline gets the best of you in there.
Jake Rattle coming at you, maybe.
If here's he gets Jake. This, it's over.
Here's a, wait a minute. Going over for Jake the Snake.
What is going on here?
Pandemonium. Look at this. Pandemonium. Brutus is in there with a pair of scissors about 9 feet long. The Macho Man with leather in his hand. On a Honky Tonk Man, let's get the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee has disqualified both men. A double disqualification.
I don't know about that.
I do. Turn into total chaos. What else are you going to do?
Yeah, Dragon. Well, who came into the ring first, I wonder?
Jake the Snake, the initial move.
No, it was Davis. Davis is the first guy who came in the ring.
Let's go back and take a look. Maybe we can pick it up.
Yeah, maybe we will pick it up. I hope that we can see it. Here we go. He's getting ready for Shake, Rattle, and Roll, okay? I think at this point...
And there you see. You see Jake the Snake. Jake the Snake trying to...
But
stopped him, but look at this now. Here's Davis coming in the ring and hitting Steamboat from the back.
Macho Man takes care of Davis, and then it all broke loose in the ring. The Dragon, Ricky Steamboat, this Thursday, the Macho Man leading his team into the Survivor Series.
Sweet Greg Valentine, it's you and I. And when I get done strutting, baby, I'm gonna take these suckers and I'm gonna do some cutting. The blonde hair's gonna be flying everywhere, and I just can't wait.
You know something, Brutus Fruitcake? This is the match that I've been waiting a long, long time for. You say first it's a strut, and then it's a cut. Well, I'm gonna take you to school, boy. And I'm not talking about barber school. I'm talking about wrestling school.
Ladies and gentlemen, the spectacular is coming this Thursday evening. 50 World Wrestling Federation superstars will be assembled on teams in a first-ever Survivor Series, and this man, the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant, will captain a team against Hulk Hogan's team.
Well, what Hulk Hogan's team is going to do is try to protect Hulk Hogan from this man getting his hands on it. Well, it's not going to happen. That's why I went to the Slickster. I've got the natural Butch Reed. I've got another giant of a man, the one-man gang, along with Rick Rude, Ravishing Rick Rude, King Kong Bundy. Hogan, it is over.
Ken Patera, Paul Orndorff, some of the names on Hulk Hogan's team.
I mean, do you think that that's going to intimidate a team who has the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant, as a captain? You know, the people know from time to time the Brain and myself have put our collective minds together, and we've come up with nothing but success. So when the Brain says, brother, let me have a gang, let me have a natural, I say, right on, brother, because we're going to get down.
Don Morocco, Bam Bam Bigelow.
Well, The Rock, Don Morocco, he's really changed. Well, you've only changed for the worse, because you're not going to be around that long. This man has plans, and his plans include Hulk Hogan. Thanksgiving night, we're going to have a 300-pound turkey named Hulk Hogan. Now, what happens if, let's say, the natural grabbed this arm, and then the one-man gang got that arm, and then Ravishing Rick Rude grabbed the leg. Bundy got that. Then what is left for Andre the Giant?
This contest is scheduled for one fall. In the ring from San Francisco, California, weighing 270 pounds, Brutus the Barber Beefcake. The Barber, he is something else. Let's take you now, ladies and gentlemen, to Jesse the Body Ventura, whom we are told is back in the dressing room area with Greg the Hammer Valentine.
This is Jesse the Body Ventura, and I finally get to do my own opening, and a better one it'll surely be. Greg the Hammer Valentine, many athletes face mid-career crisis. You've got to make a change midstream. You've got a big change happening right now, Hammer. Let the people out there know what the body already knows.
Well, Jesse, you know the success that I've had in the World Wrestling Federation, holding two titles in the times that I've been in the World Wrestling Federation. But I'm more excited about what I've got to tell the fans right now than any of those two previous titles that I've held.
Surprise them!
Surprise!
Valentine and Hart! Valentine and Hart! The new alliance! Up to the ring, gentlemen! They're waiting for you there! All right!
The Doctor of Style, the Slickster to his Jive Soul Bro, of course, and the natural Butch Reed! Get to the subject of the interview. What is the cause for this celebration?
That's right, brother. We're going to have us a little celebration. It's going to be a party. Yes, sir. That's right, home. It's going to be a party because any time that you hear the music, Jive Soul Bro, the song, it means it's time to party. You know why?
Why?
Because take a look at the brother. Take a good look at him. You know what he's done? The brother has gone out and done Superstar Billy Graham in.
Yes, sir. And I feel real good about it, baby. You know what? I feel so good about doing that. Nothing happened to my head. It tingles in my toes. And it goes all the way up to my brain. And it makes my hair curl earlier. You understand?
Gentlemen, are you trying to say you feel good about putting a man out of his livelihood, out of his career, out of pro wrestling?
I feel good about it. I feel so good about it. If I get the opportunity to do it again, I'll do it again.
Let me tell you something. While you gentlemen may feel good now, what about The Rock, Don Morocco?
What did he say, Morocco? Let me tell you something about Morocco. He stuck his fat, snotty nose in my business before. And I tell you what, Morocco, the same thing that happened to Superstar will happen to you, boy, because a hero like yourself ain't nothing but a sandwich. And I'm hard bread, and I know how to sandwich meats. So you tell Morocco that. Let's party. I don't want you. Let's party. Give me some music, somebody, baby. Hey!
Obviously, the Slickster and the Natural very pleased about what they did to Superstar Billy Graham. In fact, next week, we will have a major announcement from Superstar.
Oh, I know what that announcement's going to be. He's going to announce he's retiring. See, Billy Superstar Graham is a 100% quitter.
That's an out-and-out lie, Brain. Plenty more action still to come here on Wrestling Challenge. We'll be back in a moment.
Get down, girl.